Welcome back to the Ed Schultz Show. I'm Mike Papantonio sitting in for Ed Schultz. Republicans and their corporate masters, for years, they've been trying to keep the truth about climate change from reaching the American public. They don't want it to reach their ears. They don't want it to reach their brains. They've worked to tell us that the Earth isn't getting hotter. There's no scientific consensus that global climate change is real, or that climate change is a good thing, they even tell us, because it's going to open up shipping routes in the Arctic. Well, anyway, I have Chris Mooney with me. Chris is the author of The Republican War on Science and Unscientific America. I want to talk to you about the attacks on climate science.
You bet.
And so what is happening right now? This is now part of our school system. They're trying to teach it in our schools.
It's the next school-level fight over science education. We've been fighting over the teaching of evolution for decades and decades, right? But now climate change has gotten so politicized, even as environmental science courses want to teach kids about what's happened to the planet. So we find that when they try to teach accurate climate science, angry conservative parents start trouble.
Okay, so the idea is, you know, you got the Republican movement that they say, you know, we don't want science. We want to live in this dumbed down fantasy world. And now it's not good enough that they should do it by themselves. They want to make sure your children lived in a dumbed-down science world. It's not just about dumbing down the science about evolution anymore. Now it's dumbing down the science about something that could kill this planet, climate change.
Exactly. And they're incredibly sure of themselves. They're sure there's no global warming. They're sure that scientists just cooked it up and it's a liberal plot and the scientists cook the data. Because they're so certain, although they have no basis for being certain, because they are, they think that they really have to get in there and change what's being taught. And so these fights are already erupting, and I certainly predict that there are going to be more and more and more of them.
Well, they're being paid for by corporate America. I mean, anytime you have corporate America pumping money into all kinds of movements like the Tea Party, and now it's let's dumb down America, let's not educate our children that we've burned up their planet, let's not let them know that corporations and the American political Republican conservative machine is allowing their planet to be burned down, let's keep it quiet. Isn't that kind of the approach? Because if we let kids know about it, they might do something about it.
Sure, I think that's part of it, but I actually think that the conservative right in the U.S. has become so extreme that it doesn't even have to be corporate inspiration. It's just this really hard-line right-wing view that we have the only reality and we have to enforce it upon others.
Yeah, okay, so already we're working against numbers where they've spent, you've had Exxon, you know, do everything from hire experts to write fraudulent articles. They've admitted they did that. Then they told us they are going to stop doing it. So they pay what I call biostitutes, that is a scientist that will work for, you know, pay me enough money and I don't really care about telling the truth. You pay me enough money and supplement my professorship here at this university and I'm going to write something that you want to hear. So they attack it that way. They pay them anywhere between $10,000 to $100,000 per article and per speaking engagement. And then the next thing they do is say, okay, well, let's go to our schools. How are they going to the schools? What are they doing to get inside these schools?
Well, what's happened so far is it seems like, I don't know if I can tie it to a particular corporation, but it seems like what happens with Los Alamitos School District, which is the one that's having one of these fights right now, and I believe that this is in California in the Orange County area. It seemed like there was one highly politicized member of the school board who learned that they were teaching an environmental science class, an AP environmental science class. And so, of course, you got to teach the kids what global warming is because it's going to be on the test. And so this guy learned about that, and he tried to force the teacher to inject, quote, balance into the curriculum so that they would hear two sides of the facts. Of course, that's absurd. There aren't two sides on these facts. It's a fact that humans are causing global warming, and kids have to answer that right on the test.
Well, what bothered me is you had Scholastic, this behemoth organization's publishing group, Scholastic. I mean, they're the same people, aren't they? The Big Red Dog and Harry Potter. I mean, they're the same people who brought us that. So now they're creating. One good example is that they sent sent information out about 66,000 classrooms talking about how coal was the answer to all of our problems, and come to find out, it's nothing more than just a pitch for the coal industry.
True. The thing about that one is, and this was outrageous, right? Because Scholastic had a curriculum, and it's got such publishing power. That it sent out that was clearly just greenwashing. and it was telling kids, oh, you know, coal makes your life better in all these ways. Not anything about, you know, all of the things that coal does that's bad. But actually, Scholastic, because of pressure, you know, withdrew this curriculum. Mm-hmm. So that's actually something of a positive.
Yeah, well, I guess that's a small victory.
Yeah.
Okay, so how do you fight this? What do you do? You're a parent. Your child comes home and says, teacher can't talk about global climate change. Teacher can't talk about evolution. I've got the school board, the principal are a bunch of dimwits who buy into this whole conservative thing. And let me just tell you something. This happens right around where I live, so I know it happens. What do you do about it?
Well, it's incredibly difficult in this instance in particular, because with evolution, which is where we learned how to fight right-wing attacks on the science curriculum, we had this incredible weapon that we could use that we can't use in the climate case. And the incredible weapon is called the First Amendment of the Constitution, has this clause about separation of church and state. Anti-evolutionism is religious. So you just sue under the First Amendment, and you win every time.
Mm-hmm.
And we've won every time. And it makes it stop to some extent, although there's still teachers out there teaching creationism all across America who apparently are not getting into any trouble. But it works in the courts. Climate change, I think that there is an aspect of religion, quote-unquote religion, to climate denial, but I don't think you can win that case in court.
Yeah. So we know the way they do that. You remember, I know you followed this, about 20 years ago, the Republicans made this proclamation that they were going to start building out from, I mean, Bachman, school board, Sarah Palin, school board, then commissioner. I mean, they start with the school board. That's where they start really infiltrating the process. They you know, have these boobs come up there and, you know, they whatever it is they want to say, they say, well, we have to change all of that by changing the way our teachers teach. And by the way, changing our textbooks. Texas, for example, I mean, you know the story there. They actually rewrote history. They rewrote evolution. They rewrote science so that they could dumb down their children even more. And nobody was there to fight that. And to me, it doesn't sound like this is a fight that you should have only if you have a child in school. If you're just an American citizen and you hear this is going on in your community, isn't this something you ought to be involved with?
Oh, this is outrageous to everybody who cares about the minds of children and how they're being shaped. And for me, you know, I'm increasingly, as a science journalist, a political journalist, I'm trying to focus on the psychology of our politics, because I think that doesn't get enough attention. And when you look at something like this from that perspective, you realize how awful it is. Because from the perspective of the brain, what you're basically teaching kids to do is to have rapid-fire emotional political responses when they hear about science, rather than thinking, learning, stepping back, being calm, being unemotional, and weighing the evidence. The parents have already laid down this neural circuitry that makes them respond in this incredibly aggressive, activist way whenever they hear climate change. The last thing we want is to lay down the same kind of circuits in our kids.
Yeah, but we're doing that.
Yep.
Chris Mooney, thanks for keeping up with the story. It's too painful to have to keep up with. I'm glad you're keeping up with it. It seems to be developing. Hopefully, the more we shine light on it, the more we have a chance of making it go away. Chris Mooney, the attacks on climate science, they're taking place right in our schools. Thanks for joining me.